Hi, and welcome to the Semilines podcast. I'm Chris Torrance. In today's episode, I want to show off a brand new feature of my Apple II emulator and also listen to some cool Ultima 5 music. So let's get started. Several months ago, Michael Morrison, who also goes by the handle Code by the Pound, contacted me and wanted to work on my Apple II TS emulator. I was more than happy to have him help because there were so many features that I wanted to implement, but I just couldn't do all of them. The first thing that he tackled was adding support for printing. And so you'll notice now there is a virtual printer down here in the emulator. And if you print from, say, print shop, or just from the command line in the Apple II, it'll go to that virtual printer and then you can bring up the page and look at the output and save it to a PDF or onto disk. So that was super cool. However, the even cooler thing that he did was adding support for MIDI. MIDI is a standard for transmitting and receiving synthesizer sounds that was first developed back in 1983 and was quickly adopted by a lot of software and hardware companies as a way to exchange electronic music between, say, a computer and an electronic piano or synthesizer. For the Apple II, there were several different MIDI solutions that came out. However, the Passport card and software was probably the most popular and worked the best. We can see here an article from 1984 in the Electronics and Music Maker magazine about the Passport MIDI software for the Apple II. At the time, it came with a whole series of floppy disks as well as an interface card. The price was $195 for the card itself as well as the sequencing software for another $100. This was a fantastic solution for musicians who wanted to explore the interface between computers and synthesizers, as it provided an easy out-of-the-box experience, and you could either play notes from your computer or hook up a synthesizer. Now, Michael's idea was to recreate the Passport MIDI card in the Apple II TS emulator. However, in his case, he wanted to hook it up to Web MIDI. The Web MIDI API is a standard for web browsers to communicate with MIDI devices. And these could be either virtual devices in the web browser or actual physical devices hooked up to your computer. So what Michael did is he developed an interface between the MIDI card for the Apple II and the Web MIDI API. We can take a quick look at his code. The software for MIDI support consists of three different pieces. The first couple pieces are over on the emulator side, and this is to simulate the Passport card as well as other clones such as the Yamaha. And this has two different pieces. The first one here in this Passport file is the simulating the Motorola 6850 asynchronous communications chip. And this is essentially just a giant switch statement of all of the messages that you can pass back and forth. And then these interface with the 6840 timer chip. And to do this, we had to add support for interrupts to my emulator. Hopefully, I'll have some time in another video to go through that. This code handles the interface between the programmable timer of the 6840 and the interrupts of the 6502 in the emulator. And then finally, the third piece is this MIDI interface file, and this handles the communication between the emulator and the Web MIDI API, which is how the emulator actually talks to the web browser. So enough talking about all this, let's see it in action. If I go over to my emulator, you can see that we have a new button down here, which looks like a MIDI input port. And if we click on that, we can see the different MIDI devices that are available on my system. In my case, I only have one. One thing you might have to do, depending upon your system, is actually enable MIDI devices. If you're on a Mac, you can do this with the MIDI setup program, and you just fire up Audio MIDI Setup, and there should be at least one device called an IAC driver. You can see I have another one here for a synthesizer. If you click on that, You might need to click on the device is online to actually enable it. So once you've done that, you can go back to your web browser, and there's various websites that you can go to verify that your browser actually supports Web MIDI. So far, I've tried this in Chrome and Firefox, and it works in both. Unfortunately, Safari doesn't have support for Web MIDI. I'm assuming, though, that this would work on Windows systems through, say, the Chrome browser or through Firefox. Now, we actually need some sort of MIDI output source. There's many of these available. I'm using one called MIDI.city, which I heard about from Roger Wagner. And you can just go to the website and load it up, and it just comes up looking like a piano. And then if we go back to the emulator, let's bring in our favorite music program, which is Ultima 5. And once this starts, we can say activate music. And we will say change music configuration. And you can see that Ultima 5 is actually one of the few Apple II programs, especially games, that had support for MIDI devices out of the box. So you can see if I select G, then this will select the Passport MIDI device, which I know is in slot 2. And then once we've selected that, we will just hit return and go over to the devices and number of voices. We will choose 8 because I think that's the maximum that Ultima 5 will do. And then we'll just go down to, say, the Ultima theme and just press enter. If we go over to the MIDI website, you can see it's actually playing here and it's highlighting notes to the best of its ability. Now the fun thing is, because we have a MIDI device, we can actually change the instrument. So Ultima 5 recommends piercing brass for the ultimate theme. So let's see if we can pick that. An entire brass section. Let's try another song. How about The World's Below? And this recommends low strings. So let's get it going. All right, I am over here in the living room with a Donner DEP20 synthesizer, and I've got Ultima 5 running here on the computer. And if I pull down the MIDI device select tab, you can see right now it only has one choice, which was just the version built into the Mac. However, let me turn on the piano here, and let me just stress, this is a totally normal synthesizer. There's nothing special. It just has a USB MIDI port out on the back. So I have a USB A to USB C cable. And now, if I pull down the drop list, it might be hard to see, but there's now two choices. One is the regular built-in one, and the other one is a piano MIDI device.
it's already selected, so I don't have to do anything. And if I go, I already have my port set to slot 2 for the passport, and I can just go down to play music. And here is the music, and number of voices is 8. One thing I haven't figured out is how to actually change the voice on the synthesizer. So it has buttons up here for doing the voices, but that only appears to affect the actual keys themselves, but not what's coming out of the MIDI port. And I don't know if this is a limitation of my synthesizer or the actual MIDI device itself just isn't sending the proper commands. But regardless, it's still cool that you can have a physical instrument like this playing the MIDI sounds from the Apple II emulator. I'd like to give 2 thumbs up to Michael Morrison for his amazing job that he did on the MIDI support in the Apple II TS emulator. I was just blown away when I saw it. He just briefly mentioned that he was working on MIDI, but I didn't fully comprehend it until I actually saw it in action. And it really just blew me away that you could hook up a emulator in the browser to either a MIDI device running in another tab or to an actual physical device connected to your modern computer. So thanks a lot to Michael for doing that amazing job. In the meantime, there's a lot of other features that I've been working on in my emulator. I still need to make a video about Mockingboard support, but I just put that on hold because I just thought this other stuff was even cooler than that. So look forward to that in the future. If you're not currently a subscriber to my YouTube channel, I'd appreciate it if you would hit the subscribe button below. Once I get enough subscribers, I'll be able to actually turn off ads for my channel, which would be fantastic. And I also have a Patreon if you'd like to support me that way, and I have a link in the show notes for that. Once again, thanks for watching.